You want me to read it? We'll just
Kalosas Vrikame! Hey, thank you everyone for joining us today on a really special episode of Cooking with Greek People, because it is my lovely co-host Aurora's 21st birthday. Yes. How's it feel to be this old?
It feels like I can do whatever I want now.
No,
as in, I can go to a restaurant and not be afraid.
You can go to a restaurant and order a drink.
Yeah, like people can invite me places now, you know? Because okay. All my friends are 21, so now I can join them.
I can go to dinner. And so where did you guys go yesterday?
We went to Javier's in Crystal Cove. It was really nice.
That's like in the Laguna Beach area in California, in Crystal Cove. Javier's very fancy restaurant.
It is very fancy. I got the enchiladas, my favorite.
What cocktail did you drink?
Jalapeno margarita.
Jalapeno margarita. You know, we're going to have to talk to Stelios later about whether he can authenticate that it came from Mexico or not. But that's wonderful. Congratulations on your birthday. We really need to get the clap thing.
Yeah.
Thank you everybody out there for joining us. So that's wonderful to have you here, helping us celebrate Aurora's 21st birthday. And this is episode 56. And this is a great episode because today we're going to be authenticating the region of origins of food. So we have a special guest straight from Chania Crete, Greece, the founder of BIOCOS, and his name is Dr. Stelios Athondakis, and he has a PhD in this area, and he's the founder of this laboratory. And it is a biotech company building a foundation of a sustainable future via DNA science. So they use DNA data, and it comes to life, and it delivers end-to-end DNA traceability solutions from field to store in the food. So that means that they're able, if you say that, hey, this is feta cheese, and feta is a product of Greece, you know it's feta cheese. It came from Greece. If it's a kalamata olives, you want to make sure those olives came from kalamata. If it's, there's so much variety of food that Greece has that it's wonderful to have a company like this that can hit home with it.
Yeah.
And, you know, there's chefs that are real interested in this sort of thing too. So we have from Nafplio, Greece, which is the first city of Greece. It was the first capital when Greece got its independence. We have executive chef Panagiotis Kokkalas and executive chef Tasos, Tolis. And they're from Greco-Path and the first house of Greek food, which is a restaurant. And they're going to be joining us as well. But to start with, we're going to spend some time talking to Stelios. So let's bring him on. And we were going to say, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us. And, you have such a, when you have a company that is based in Greece, so you have a Greek company, and it's in the biotech sector, which isn't something you typically associate with Greece. And so I thank you for making that turnaround for Greece. You know, that's wonderful that now, Greece has, and they probably have had for years and years, but having a laboratory of this kind. So can you tell us about what got you thinking about this and why you started, and why is it necessary to have a lab like yours?
Well, it was, the company was founded in 2016. I have spent, Bob, approximately before founding the company, 15 years in research. So I wanted to change this a little bit. I realized that in Europe, of course, in US even earlier, there were a lot of companies driving the knowledge into the market, providing solutions that have an effect on the society and the environment. Because at the end, whatever we produced must have an effect for the future, positive effect. to clarify this. So I decided to leave research, start transferring what the experience acquired in bioinformatics particularly, you know, these magic things you do with a computer that nobody understands. And that way we began working and growing this small company with a lot of effort, a lot of collaborations, network. We collaborate with universities abroad, Greece, with Canada. We have clients abroad, Greece. And I would like to add a note. I think Greece has started showing a very powerful, with a lot of potential, biotech environment. And I think it is in the hands of a new generation that they bring, they have the will to create innovation and products to put in the market. And so we have a good background. We have excellent scientists in the research institutes. We have a good number of excellent research institutes that have young people with knowledge, capacities. So now I think we are growing in this stage, slowly, but I think we can manage to create a good, trustful biotech environment also in Greece. It needs time, effort, and patience. So the idea was to transfer this knowledge and work on the DNA verification of products. So where do the products come from and how we could help this to deliver traceability and authentication of raw materials that are used in food industry. So we used a nice recipe. We put a little bit of bioinformatics, we put a little bit of lab, and we start creating the foundations of the technology. And now we are in the market providing DNA verification of the olive oil, but also for the olive fields, the olives, in the food, cosmetics, and supplements, and also in herbs that we use. So we start finding a good market to advance the technology and provide solutions.
Oh, that's fantastic. So. So we're getting a little feedback now. So tell me, is it when you do this sort of thing, do companies come to you and see it as a value proposition for what they create?
I think there are three main advantages in the traceability for a company. And of course, one, it is offers a differentiation of the product if it is traceable. So they can gain the trust of the consumer. You know, modern consumer is rapidly changing. The new generation of consumers wants to have a transparent label. They want to know the ingredients, where do they come from, because they have they're more sensible towards the sustainability of the environment and the society. In terms of society, I intend the producers. Because the producers, if you support producers, then the society has more, let's say, it is also economically healthier. And in that way, they protect the nature that delivers the ingredients for a food product. So it has three segments. Of course, the financial, let's say, they love more clients for a product that it is traceable, which is very logical in a business in the business. They have the sustainability because they protect the source and the origin of the raw materials, and the society because they support the local producers. So it is, I think it offers a lot and it will keep growing and can be an excellent tool to put, let's say, to play an important role in the future of our in the future of our planet also.
Right. Yeah, no, absolutely. But I also see it on a very kind of micro level, the future of Greece, because Greece isn't a large economy, but it has a tremendous brand recognition when it comes to like the Mediterranean diet. I mean, which is the FDA here in the United States, the Food and Drug Administration promotes that diet to live cancer free. You know, it's like these sort of things. So if you have a product, identifying a product that is part of that ecosystem that developed that diet, I think is very important.
Do you remember, I think in the 60s, Greece, in particular Crete, had the most healthy diet in the world. It was a study that had performed a Greek researcher, I think it was Kafatos, that he was president of European Molecular Biology Society. So we need to preserve these characteristics. Greece has a low quantity of production of products, but we have an excellent quality. So we have to preserve and protect the quality in order to be more competitive in the food industry. We don't have this, you know, I imagine the United States, you have huge areas of cultivation that technology is easy, it is useful, accessible. Greece has low quantity, so the products must be of higher quality. This way, we will be able to sustain all this natural, let's say, treasure we have. And it is an important step to invest in low cost also technology, because DNA is a low cost. It is not robotics sensors that cost thousands, but it is a low cost technology that gives an advantage.
Right. You know, that's what I'm looking at too. I mean, kind of get back to Crete for a moment, which is where I'm from as well. It's one of the things that baffled people, scientists after World War II, is that Greece didn't starve after all the, let's say, the industrial foods or the foods that were made on a mass scale from the farms were confiscated by the Nazis. Crete, the people in Crete knew how to forage. They knew, you know, like vlita, you know, that's a superfood. They know I'm growing it here in my backyard. I brought some spores with me.
You should send me.
Don't tell anybody. but you know, that's the kind of thing that an occupying army doesn't take advantage of. They want the industrial stuff. But they were baffled why people in Crete were able to. They were actually probably healthier than before the occupation, because you know, they relied more on these wild greens for their diet.
Own resources.
Yeah. Resources. Right. And one of the things that, one of the reasons I wanted you to be here, we'll have Panagiotis on in a few minutes with their organization, is because they look at creating sustainability for these villages, especially into the 21st century here, where these villages will not survive if we continue down the path that we have for the last 50, 60 years. But if we look at it from what the villages have to offer, that is more, that is really a much robust way of living and the much healthier way of producing food. You know, if we can, I think they can take advantage of that in the boutique market, whereas they wouldn't really be able to compete with factory farms.
Keep in mind, I would like to give you a few numbers. Keep in mind that in Greece we are the third producing country in olive oil in the world. And I'm not sure we will stay for many years because it's growing in also in Asia, the olive oil cultivation. But keep in mind that 80% of our olive oil is extra virgin olive oil, which only 27% approximately, let's say 30%, just to be is bottled and branded in Greece.
Oh wow.
So we lose a huge quantity of a valuable product, which could be a power into the olive oil industry in the market as a high-end product. And I am almost certain that the first olive oil in Greece, here in Crete, in Chania, received the health benefits that it has, the health, you know, as a health product, extra virgin olive oil. So these are products that we need to protect, support, promote, and help them to gain market. And this is, for example, technologies like ours can do. We, in Europe only, is exported within Europe, exported and imported between the European countries, more than 1 million tons of olive oil goes around.
Wow.
So,
and yet Greece loses 70% of that, of its capacity, because it isn't able to do a value add. It isn't able to create the extra virgin portion of it.
It is has aimed to a different, marketing strategy, which I can receive. You cannot. These are decisions of the people that they prefer to do a different commercial strategy, export their olive oil as bulk.
Right.
But this, to be changed, you need to give them the motivation of a higher profit at the end.
Right.
So they can invest time and do a long, and start building a very solid strategy of promoting this valuable product.
Yeah, and, you know, I noticed, one of the things I noticed was that the boutique markets that I shop at, which are kind of aimed towards kind of like a higher end product, are featuring more localized Greek products. So the large white beans, now it isn't just one maker of it, you know, the typical one you find in Greece. Now you can find one that looked like came from a village in Greece. And so that really kind of fascinates me. I'm very happy to see that, because I think that's where the sustainability is going to come from, is being able to buy these products being able to create products from a very localized market in Greece. It would be nice to get olive oil from Chania in these stores, and I do get it once in a while, but usually the olive oil that's, in fact, I think I have some.
Yeah.
Hey, can you bring the tin out? Would you mind getting that?
Tin.
Yeah, the big tin. Yeah, it's because usually what we would buy is, it would be from like Kalamata, let's say, and we wouldn't get we wouldn't be able to find something from, like, let's say, from Chania or from Erapetra or from these other areas.
No, we do have excellent companies.
Yeah, and I'm looking here. This is what I have, and it's from Chania.
I cannot see.
Mythology, extroverted.
Koli Mavri from Chania.
I cannot see anymore. I'm getting old.
It's Kolibari. It's from Kolibari.
Kolibari. It's a pop area. Kolibari is a pop area. Pop, it is a PGO, I think. Yes. The
well,
PGO.
Yeah, and it's it says here that's
protected geographic origin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which is the kind of thing that makes me very happy, that I can buy something that is like from your neighborhood, right?
We work with companies there. We know that the last year there are a lot of, again, young people mainly, that they have and good companies in Greece that they start trying to do this change. To do this, to invest in quality. There are a lot of things going on. And I think we are in the beginning of a momentum. It is the momentum, you know, it's like you're surfing and you're waiting the good wave. So they're positioned, many of them now waiting to go with the wave. And I think this in 5 years, we will see a lot of changes in this sector.
Well, you know, I've got a couple of people online right now that are very happy to hear that. So let me, Stelios, hang on. I'm going to bring on a couple of more people to the stream. And I'm going to bring on, hopefully, I have Executive Chef Panagiotis Kokkalas here. Hopefully, I have, he's from Greco Paths in the first house of Greece. And hopefully, we're going to have Executive Chef Tasos as well. Hi, are you guys ready? They may not be as ready as, let's just see here. I think they're getting set. Hi, Yasas. Yasas. Masakus. Okay, we're gonna say Daniel. Daniel, thank you for watching. Carlos Sabato. And Sandy, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, there you go. Yasas, Masakus.
Yes, Masakus.
Masakus, bravo, ωραία.
Εντάξει.
Καλά, ναι. Γεια σας, ακούμε.
Άκουσα για το κολυμπάρι. Και να σου δείξουμε, κοίταξε, κάλα εδώ. Ωραίο κολυμπάρι. Το έκανα το κολυμπάρι με το κάτι χρόνια στο κερδό της Ελλάδας.
Yeah, thank. Ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ that you've joined us today.
Εδώ θα σας δείξω και έξω. Έχουμε από Αμερική κόσμο, εδώ τώρα να δεις, που μπορείς να μιλήσεις και αμερικάνικα.
Ah, γεια σας. Oh, we are so jealous. Ζηλεύουμε.
Yeah.
Ζηλεύουμε τώρα, παιδιά.
Εδώ πίτα μέσα και κάνετε για τα λάδια και τα κολυμπάρι. Αφού είστε στα εστιατόρια για τα
λάδια. Γεια σας.
Όχι μόνο βιοτεχνολόγο, μηχανικό τροφίμων και αυτός είναι DNA. Εδώ.
Εγώ σπουδάζω, δεν έχω τελειώσει ακόμη.
Εδώ που βλέπεις είναι στην Κρήτη και είναι αυτός που έχει κάνει το DNA τροφίμων.
Το CSI.
Το CSI.
Κοιτάξτε, μίλατε, άλλα μέσα να δεις. Αμερική είναι τώρα εδώ.
We're in California. We're in California and we're so happy to see you. We are in California. And thank you for letting us join you.
Yeah, when you're coming here, you gotta see this place here. Did you ever see this place?
I think I'm gonna try and come there early July.
Early July? Early July? Wait,
yes, July. I'm gonna try and come there in July.
Εδώ πάμε να συνεχίσω την εκπομπή μέσα με τα τζουκνιδόπιτα. Λοιπόν, πάμε. Έλα εδώ να δεις τώρα τι είναι και την τζουκνιδόπιτα.
Thank you.
Έλα.
So, hey, let's talk to you for a minute. Να σας μιλήσουμε μια στιγμή. Να μας πεις, how important is this to you, that identifying the region of origin of the food that you make?
Να το πούμε λίγο στα ελληνικά και να το πεις εσύ μετά στα αγγλικά.
Ναι, να μας πεις στα ελληνικά.
Εγώ για την τυπνίδα έχω γράψει, θέλετε.
Ωραία. Πες που θες στα αγγλικά εδώ. Γιατί μας λείπει και η Σταυρούλα, είναι με δημοσιογράφο Αμερικάνο τώρα κάτω στο Νάφπλιο.
It's okay.
Καλησπέρα σας από μένα.
Πες τα αγγλικά.
We will speak about the nettle.
It belongs to the family of fountain family. Is an annual or perennial herbaceous plant with 40 species worldwide. Has healing properties and it's used as a beverage herb, salad, soup, pies, greens, rich in calcium, potassium, vitamin C, vitamin K, complex vitamins B. It's suitable for bone.
Προβατεί να καπνιστεί.
Health, iron deficiency anemia, and nervous system. Has antioxidant activity, antimicrobial, anti-inflammatory, and anti-rheumatic action. So today we used it as a pie, and we prepare it here. Now Miss Lily is going to see you.
Thank you. Ευχαριστούμε.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so are you going to show us the recipe, how you prepare this?
Έχουμε βάλει αλεύρι, έχουμε βάλει μαλλιά, έχουμε βάλει λίγο ζάχαρη για να καταλάβει τη σούπα, λίγο αλάτι, έχουμε βάλει και λίγο λάδι, έχουμε βάλει. Και μετά έχουμε βάλει και λίγο χυλερό νερό.
Oh, okay. Ωραία.
Και μια κουταλίτσα πάλι από το φως. the border, the cleaning. Έτσι. Και πάλι το κλείνει καλά, καλά στην άκρη. Για να μην ανοίγει. Πάλι έχουμε κάνει από το κλείνει.
I'm going to ask her to maybe just use one camera here.
Μπορεί και μόνο το κάνει να το κάνει με εδώ, με το κλείστα και χειρί. Ωραία.
You want to?
Just
take a picture. So what do you think, Stelios? This looks delicious, doesn't it?
Kalsunakia, it is kalsunakia with tsuknida. We make them with other greens, but
looks good.
Really nice.
I'm going to show something. Yeah, we got a big comment here. So, Stamataki, thank you for your comments. Authentic produce is very important to consumers. Can Stelio and his team authenticate more products other than olive oil? Do you think the consumers should only buy authenticated products? I think consumers should only buy products from Greece.
Just in general.
That's it.
End of the story.
End of story. And Stelios, what other products do you authenticate, Stelios?
We can authenticate actually any natural plant or other, or even let's say meat, fish. We can authenticate this. Our vertical solution is on olive oil, our main oil focus. But we have a solution for herbs like sage and some varieties of coffee. Sometimes, you know, we wait for the client to tell us what he wants while we build the solution. But, you know, DNA is everywhere. Bob, you know it better than me.
Yeah. No, I know. It's this is the sort of thing that I think, but I think this could really change the economic landscape of Greece, though. You know, it because I know people are willing to buy, you know, something created in Greece.
They want to know that it is created in Greece. They want to know that it comes from Greece.
Right. Let me say hello to a few people that are watching. Viewer number one, Yuli, thank you for watching.
And thank you. And if I stole to Nicole Rain, thank you. And hi, Phil, thank you.
I would like one of those kalsunakia.
You know, I'm trying to think of all the places I have to go to only because my, and one of the places will be this restaurant. the first house of Greek food, Greco paths. They do such a wonderful job in keeping these very, very local traditions alive. It's just incredible. And we appreciate it so much. So I can't wait to go to Greece and sample this. And I'm going to do my best to go and visit you in Chania as well, Stelios.
We will be more than happy to have you. We will discuss about non-science this time, because we talk about science often.
Yeah, we'll talk about food.
Food. And we will have a good food next to the sea and talk about life.
Wow, that looks delicious, though. Has anybody who's watching been to Nafplio recently? Put it in the comments. So it's nice to see the restaurant has, you know, guests there right now. You know, this is great. Oh, that looks delicious. Yeah, this is the sort of dish I love by, yeah, deep frying in the local olive oil, and you know, it's, to me, it's incredible. It looks so delicious. Oh my goodness, look at that.
Ooh, I want it.
So that's going to go outside to somebody that's going to eat it and make us all very jealous here.
Unfortunately, cannot reach me and you.
I know. Wow, look at that. Oh, okay, I got to put that in the big picture there, because this is going to be one of our clickbait photos. Right there. Look at that. That's delicious. See, that's, how come when I cook, I can't make it look like that? We do have the tomatoes, though. We have some tomatoes in the backyard right now. Brad, thank you for watching. Sophia, thank you for watching. Elizabeth, thank you for watching, you guys. Oh, my goodness. See, that's the way our life should be.
Always.
Oh.
Colors.
I know. It's gorgeous. Wow. And see, if you live in Nafplio, this is what you have to look forward to. If you're visiting Nafplio, plan on it, this is the place you need to go. And all the links are in the description below, so you can find at Greco Paths and First House of Greek Food in the description below. And make sure, if you're visiting, this is where you go to visit, because this is exceptional. This is wonderful. Look at that. Oh, yeah. That's fantastic. Look at that. Wow. Thank you. Wow, Tasso, you guys are doing a great job over there. So are you busy now? Are things picking up? Are people coming to the restaurant more, Tasso or Tolis? I'm not sure they can hear me. But it looks like things are picking up in Greece. How about you, Stelios? Have you found people in restaurants again, the cafes? Yes, Stelios. Have you found people going back to cafes now?
Yes. The market, you know, the old restaurants are open again, thankfully, the cafes. So it's a good brief about for our economy, you know.
Yeah.
We have, and Greece has a good, very important income from tourism. So it's good that it's start working again.
Yeah.
No, let's hope we bypass this pandemic, which will not end, but we will not have new waves and waves.
Right. No, this is, we want to all go back to Greece, want to enjoy the food, the friends, the culture, everything. So that would be wonderful. And is this Tasos? Is this, I'm not sure who's there. Or is this?
Tasos, είμαι από Ήπειρο.
Από το Ήπειρο. Oh, bravo.
Εδώ τα παιδιά, όπως βλέπεις, είναι καινούργια παραγωγή εδώ με το λάδι. Είναι όχι απλά κολυμπάρι, είναι μανάκι. Το μανάκι αυτό είναι γλυκό.
Oh.
Έχει εδώ με κάναβις, άλλο λάδι. Εδώ με σαφράν, με ρίγανη, με γεύσεις.
Oh, bravo. Oh.
Και εδώ, ας πούμε, αυτό εδώ είναι από τον Αχλαδόκαμπο 0, το οποίο είναι για Αμερική. Πάει στην Καλιφόρνια κι αυτό.
Κι αυτό, μπράβο. Ξέρεις, πρέπει
και
να
είναι για τα εστιατόρια τα όπα.
Oh, really?
Yes, από το Χερόπουλο. Είναι εδώ από το Μαλαντρένι. Όπως και έξω, έχουν πάλι ελληνικά εστιατόρια.
Μπράβο. Ωραία.
Και εδώ αυτό είναι καπνιστή προβατίνα.
So it's smoked lamb. Oh, that's
good. Η Μάρη, βότανα. Και μιλάμε και με τη μηχανική τροφίμων, με το Πανεπιστήμιο της Λάρισσας. Και σήμερα είχαμε το Πανεπιστήμιο της Πάτρας, γιατί έχουμε ένα βουνό εδώ που λέγεται Φαρμακάς, ο οποίος στείλεγε τα βότανά του ο Ασκληπιός.
Oh, beautiful. That's wonderful.
Άρα, η τσουκνίδα αυτή εδώ που βλέπετε είναι απαγορευμένη. Εδώ, στα παλιά χρόνια, χτυπάγαν τα παιδιά στα πόδια για να αποκτήσουν αντισώματα και τους φτιάγνανε με μολόχα εντριβές. Εμείς τώρα ξεκινάμε με 60 βαθμούς αλκοόλ από κρασί, βάματα με τσουκνίδα, που κάνει καλό σε 23 αρρώστιες για το σώμα.
Oh, it's a medicinal.
Οπότε η Κρήτη και η Πελοπόννησο, πάμε στους δρόμους του Μίνωα και του Πέλοπα, έχουν παγκοσμίως τα πιο πολλά βότανα από όλο τον κόσμο. Wow. Άρα αν ενώσουμε την Κρήτη και την Πελοπόννησο, δεν χρειαζόμαστε τίποτα. Μόνο την Ήπειρο στη μέση για να μας φτιάχνει πίτες. Λοιπόν,
Well said.
Στο χωριό μου λένε ότι το φαΐ και το ξύσιμο αρχή θέλουνε. Εμείς αρχίσαμε να σας ανοίγουμε την όρεξη. Εδώ όμως, όταν την περασμένη εβδομάδα είχα αντικριστό κάτω στο ποτάμι, εδώ οι χύτρες αυτές που βλέπετε από την Κρήτη, κακαβιά στο τολό και ρυφάκια, μέσα κολοκοτρονέικα, κλέφτικο, σκαμμένο μέσα, γιατί είχαμε το 1821 εδώ και αύριο θα κάνουμε εκπομπές όπως παλιά, με τη χαρτούρα, με τα πιάτα. Να θυμηθούμε τη γνήσια Ελλάδα.
Oh, bravo. That's beautiful.
Το μόνο που περιμένουμε, καλή παρέα. Καλούμε λοιπόν ένα αντάμο μακρύ την Πελοπόννησο, με τους συλλόγους που έχουμε εδώ, το λόγο και τους πάντες, να κάνουμε ανταμώματα καθώς πρέπει για την ελληνική παράδοση.
Να τρώμε.
Yeah.
Άρτον και θέαμα.
Wow. Κοίτα, ευχαριστούμε πολύ για τη παρέα, τη φιλοξενία. Είμαστε που μας έχει φέρει μέσα στο εστιατόριο σου και όλοι να το δουν.
Είς τώρα ότι κοίτα τσάι για το Αλτσάιμερ. Εδώ.
Oh, wow.
Και εδώ κοίτα τώρα. Είχαμε βροχή. Έχει τέσσερες εποχές ταυτοχρόνω. Και εκεί απέναντι είναι ναός κάθαρσης ανδρών. Είναι οι πηγές του Ινάχου. Από εδώ ήταν η Ατλαντίδα, οι Ιναχίδες. Και εδώ η οικογένεια που βλέπεις είναι από το αχλαδόκαμπο που είπαμε με το λάδι που βλέπατε μέσα.
Oh, wow.
Και είναι η νέα γενιά του αχλαδόκαμπου, όχι του κολυμπαρίου που έχετε εσείς στην Κρήτη. Λοιπόν, κοιτάξτε να δείτε
πώς... Όσο πιο πολύ, τόσο καλύτερα.
Μα είπαμε, ενώνουμε τους δρόμους του Μίνωα και του Πέλοπα και βάζουμε την Ήπειρο απλά να μας κάνει πίτες.
Μπράβο. Καλά το είπες.
Αφού είδατε τώρα και όλο το κομμάτι, κοιτάτε τώρα τι είναι το σουβλάκι. Το ελληνικό.
Oh,
yeah. Η γουρνοπούλα. Και όλο το κομμάτι εδώ. Γιάννης, Γιώργος.
Γεια σας.
Και η βροχή που όπως βλέπεις. Αυτό είναι το μικρό το χωριό. Κοίταξε να δεις το... Έχουμε τέσσερες εποχές ταυτόχρονα. Σας έβαλα λίγο στο κλίμα.
Ναι.
Α, τι ωραία πράγματα.
Και η ζωή συνεχίζεται εδώ.
Γεια. Yeah.
Λοιπόν, την Ήπειρο την βλέπετε, έτσι. Λοιπόν, ο Τόλης είναι που βλέπετε τις πίτες. Θα ακούνε, πες, συνέχισε.
Εγώ θεωρώ ότι εμείς τους Έλληνες έχουμε αρχίσει πλέον να αλλάζουμε και την διατροφή. Ήδη βρίσκουμε ταπεινά προϊόντα, όπως είναι η τσιπίδα. Έχω πολλές παρασκευές για προϊόντα από την πρωτογενή τομέα. Έχουμε πολύ καλά ελαιόλαδα. Έχουμε όλα από την όγκη, από την όγκη να έχουμε σωστή διατροφή και να ακολουθούμε τη μεσογειακή δίαιτα. Το μήνυμα είναι απλό. Γυρνάμε στην παράδοση, παίρνουμε πίσω αναμνήσεις και έχουμε πολύ ωραίες γευστικές απολαύσεις γενικά. Όλοι σε γνωρίζετε ότι στην Ελλάδα κάνουμε τη δική μας σε παρένθεση και επανάσταση που θεωρώ ότι θα έχει απήχηση σύντομα.
Ευχαριστούμε πολύ, Chef.
Εμείς ευχαριστούμε. Καλή συνέχεια και σας περιμένουμε να απολαύσουμε όλο αυτό εδώ.
Καλή
η ωραία διάθεση για να απολαύσουμε στιγμές. Ο χωροχρόνος
να μας βοηθήσει να έχουμε υγεία.
Γεια σας και από μένα.
Καλή απόλαυση.
Γεια σας, παιδιά. Γεια σας. Yeah. Ευχαριστούμε πολύ.
Καλή απόλαυση. Ναι. Με υγεία και το κολυμπάρι του χρόνου να είναι εδώ, να κολυμπήσουμε στο λάδι. Καλή συνέχεια.
Γεια σας. Στέλιος.
Γεια σας.
Bye. Well, there you go. See, the importance of what you're doing is keeping these restaurants and the, well, more than just the restaurants, it's really keeping these villages really alive, because with that import or that export of really a boutique product, they just get swallowed up.
Yes, we have excellent quality, Bob. We have good quality products. It's a pity not to add the value they deserve.
Yeah.
This is...
Well,
we are doing our best.
Yeah. Well, look, you're going to have... before we let you go, is there anything you want to add? Is there anything you want to say about your company or anything maybe we didn't touch upon? Or are...
Well, a closing remark. I don't know.
Well, it's okay. It's okay.
You blocked me.
I think we talked. Yeah.
I was thinking of the food.
Now we're gonna start celebrating her birthday here in about 30 minutes. So we're all set for that. But look, I can't.
Let me add a closing remark.
Okay.
I'm glad to see that we have in Greece good local producers and companies doing excellent quality of products. And I'm also happy to see that our biotech environment is increasing. And I'm not talking only about our company. I'm talking about other biotech companies in Greece, because union make force. So I hope we will manage to boost and help all the economy of Greece also.
As we are all. But thank you so much for taking the time today. We know you're busy and we really appreciate it.
I would walk my dog.
Okay, go walk your dog. I know you have a birthday party to get to. Ευχαριστούμε, Στέλιος.
Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Bye.
Have a great day. Bye.
Thank you.
Well, gee, I hope everybody here learned something today, because that's a very cool thing that they're doing, identifying the products and their origins, you know, where are they coming from? So, you know, if you're going to get Greek feta, you want to make sure it came from Greece. You want to make sure that the olives are from Greece. But what's really interesting that I really liked was that the olive oil that they're producing locally is making its way to the United States. And check out your boutique markets. Look at your boutique markets, look at your Whole Foods, look at the local, many times there's Middle Eastern markets, Mediterranean markets, things like that. Look over there, see if you can find the products that have been locally sourced in Greece. I've been able to find olive oil from Chania in Laguna Niguel, or actually in Laguna Hills, in California. I'm sure it appears in lots of different areas, but maybe one of the things we'll do at some point is see if we can put together a database with your help out there from all over the country. If you want to put in the comments section, hey, I found this type of olive oil in this market here in Pennsylvania or in Boston or in wherever.
Australia,
Melbourne. Melbourne, I was able to find it at this market. And these are the olive oils I saw. Take some pictures. You know, post them. We'd love to get your input on all of this. And so to all of you out there, this was episode 56 of Cooking with Greek People. And we thank you for joining us. And again, to my lovely co-host, happy 21st birthday, Aurora.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Thank you. Yassas.